QS Tony here. Just want to show you Rob Allen trigger mechanism, tear down, polish, and safety removal. We're going to remove this evil little device here. Now I want to make it clear that we are not going to be completely removing the device. We're only going to be removing portions of it. Now this is the Rob Allen Vecta 2 trigger mechanism. Came out of the good old Needlefish Slayer project, but I just want to show you how simple and easy this mechanism is. So for those of you at home who have problems and feel like they, a little overwhelming to take this thing apart, this video is to show you how easy it really is. Now, once you actually get the mechanism out of the spear gun, you're going to be left with this here. You got your line release, and you got a little sear right here, and your trigger. There's three components and two pins. So that's five whole pieces along with this little spring here, so six. Now there's two other pieces, seven, and the safety piece, and there's the spring, eight. So eight pieces all together in this whole component, and the line release actually can't be removed, so you might as well call that seven since this is stationary. Anyways, so first what we're going to do is we're going to move the trigger pin. Now the trigger is got a little spring under here that the safety connects to. So when you remove this, this trigger is going to sort of boing out. There's a little spring here. Just retain it with your fingers. Hold it down. You need a little Allen wrench to pop it out. Coax it right on out. And get this pin all the way. And slowly release the pressure. The first thing I want you to do is just remove your little spring. Just remove the trigger and the spring. We're just going to keep it together then. Now, once we have that out, you are going to have a larger spring, and we're just going to push this little safety button out. Now, this little safety button right here holds this spring that this attaches to. And not only does this adjust your trigger pull, or give you your trigger pull, but when it's actually in place like this and away, it's not in safety. When it's like this, it is in safety. So what we ultimately need to do in order to remove the safety feature is to grind this little piece down. Now, you can use a bench grinder, whatever. I am going to use a little knife, whittle it down, stain it down, and give it a nice good polish. So bear with me here, and we'll go ahead and make this as quick and painless as possible. Another nice little trick to keeping these two together, take one of these ends, sort of screw it in. It actually holds it in place. You'll see why later. I'm going to go ahead and set that aside. And we're going to focus on the sear. We've got the last two components in here, so what we're going to do is push this little pin out. Bad boy's gonna drop out. Pretty simple. That's it. Now, polish. What we want to do is we want to polish the surface areas that come in contact with other components. So that's at this end. We're just gonna polish this whole end up, and then we're gonna polish up these pins. So, get a little metal polish here. And show you some of the inside. Big difference. This is a lot more cleaner. Silky smooth. Alrighty. Now once you got this done, look inside here. Now what actually happens is this little sear here drops against this. So we need to clean inside of this here as well. So let's see if I can scoop some of this up. There we go. Line over this little smither. Doesn't need it. This trigger mech's good to go. But, you know, just make sure there's nice and easy movement here, you know, no binding. I'm gonna look inside this cassette here and see if there's any mold lines, anything like that. I mean, there's a little sharp edge here. If you really feel condemned, so you know, feel necessary, you can sort of whittle down any edges. Now, back to your trigger. So first thing what we're going to do is we're going to take the sear and we're going to reinstall this bad boy. Now what you need to do is you need to make sure that the line release is fully extended. And just line the hole up, grab your freshly polished pin, slide it in, see if we can get this, there we go. And once it's nice and flush, make sure, and you actually see that it's starting to make contact. Now, when you go to install your trigger, again, make sure that your line release is fully extended to keep the sear dropped down. And you're going to get the little safety device that we're removing in its entirety. Right here like this, and you're gonna reinstall. Just make sure that that little nub's down and that this little spring is nice and installed in place. And make sure that's good to go. All right, now drop the line release. You don't have to worry about this first initial, this little spring here just yet, but you do need to make sure that this little button here comes in contact with the spring. And you don't need to put much tension on it, but you'll see the hole eventually line up. You just want to make sure that sear is dropped all the way. And you might have to finagle it a little bit, but whoop, sear dropped. There we go. Nope, slid right in. Now, make sure that the spring stayed in place. And on, get your trigger pull. Now, take your. Look at that! It actually spits the shaft out. And we accidentally bumped the safety. Trigger mech still goes in and still fires. QS Tony. Polish trigger mechanism, remove safety. You can super glue this bad boy in if you want, but that's that.